Today I'm going to share with you my two favorite ways for painting lines. The first way is going to use a nylon flat. The second way, I'll use a liner brush. Sometimes we call these a script liner or even a script brush. In order to paint well-defined lines, we're going to have to thin the paint out a little bit. I like to use about one part acrylic glazing liquid, one part water, and one part paint. If you don't have a spray bottle filled with water, you can simply add water via your palette knife or even an eyedropper. The acrylic glazing liquid looks white, but it dries clear. If the paint is too thick, you'll have a hard time. Practice with different consistencies and you'll find out what works best for you. Most often, I know the paint's ready when it drips off the end of the palette knife. This is a nylon flat brush. Once wet, the nylon flat brush is great for painting lines and sharp edges. Don't try this with a hog hair brush or a natural brush. Those types of brushes, the fibers split apart, and while they're great for blending paint, they're not very good for painting sharp edges and lines. I could use this brush like so to paint some lines. I can press a little harder and get a little bit thicker stroke out of it. Now that's one way to do it. The other way is with the liner brush. Make sure your paint is still nice and fluid. Take the liner brush and load it with paint by pushing forward, rotating the bristles a few times, splitting those fibers apart. If you just drag the brush through the paint, it won't actually load the brush. It'll just superficially put the paint on the outside. You want to press down and push all that paint into the fibers. Once it's loaded, feel free to drag a little bit if you have some excess on there. We're ready to go. This is a fairly thick liner brush. If you want even thinner lines, just use a thinner brush. This is a number 6.